Hi, everybody.
Tis I,
Miss Tina Z, your favorite gender nonconforming ukulelist and vocalist. How y'all doing today? I'm well, thank you for asking. I assume you did. To be polite, at least. Real good, real good. Ow. Ow. Tangled hair. Did you see this dress? Did you see it? Filled with roses. It's rose patterned. Hello. Hello. What happened? You fell down. Let me try that again. I've worn the dress before. I don't remember for what song. But this is the second wearing, which is an unusual thing for me, especially for a dress that's this gaudy, I want to say. Gaudy, not ugly. I don't think it's ugly. It is gaudy. There's nothing subtle about it. It looks as though someone was staying at a Motel 6 in 1975, and she needed a dress immediately and ripped down the curtains and sewed this thing. But again, not ugly. Not ugly, but yeah. This will be my last wearing. This is now for sale. For sale, size 14. Yes. 14. For my Spanish-speaking friends. So I'm wearing it for a particular reason. I'm playing the song Every Rose Has Its Thorn by Poison, which, much like this dress, is not an ugly song, but it is gaudy. Nothing subtle about it. Nothing subtle about it. It was huge, huge hit in the 1980s. 1988, if Wikipedia is to be believed, is on the album Open Up, Poison's album Open Up and Say Ah. I'm sorry, there's no question mark at the end of it, but there's an ellipses in between Say and Ah. It's Open Up and Say Ah. And I know something about the language, and if you use ellipses, that's generally use it for one of two reasons. One is to indicate that you've eliminated words from your sentence. I don't believe that can be it, because it's not, I don't know what well-known phrase that could be. Open up and say to your friends, ah. I don't know, like there would be words missing. The other reason to use an ellipsis is to indicate a pregnant pause, drama. But I don't even know in that sentence why you would do that. Open up and say, ah. Whatever. Anyway, it was a huge hit. That album was massive for the band. I believe that was their second album, or maybe third, I don't know. But it was huge, and this hit song, Every Rose Has Its Thorn, was a number one song. Yay, Poison! I believe their only number one hit on the Billboard Hot 100. Pretty sure of that. I'm going to put that here, a little trophy for me if I win. Yay! What else do you need to know about it? I don't know. I have a suspicion. Okay, so this is a conspiracy more than anything. But I have a suspicion that Poison put out their first album, and it did well. The first album was called Look What the Cat Dragged In, I believe. I think that was their first major release. Let me verify that with what you call the Wikipedia. The power of all American poison. Okay, Poison. Here we go. What does Wikipedia say? I believe, my guess, is that Look What the Cat Dragged In was their first release. Whatever. Talk dirty to me. Blah, 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 blah. What's the history? Discography. Look What the Cat Dragged In. 1986. Look What the Cat Dragged In. Yay. And that was a rockin' good time debut album. Talk Dirty to Me was on that. I Won't Forget You. I Want Action. Yea for those poisoners. Yay for the poisoners. 1986. 1986 was the same year as Slippery When Wet by Bon Jovi. Some people classified those two bands in the same genre. And perhaps, maybe, yeah, maybe. Arguments can be made both ways. But regardless, on Bon Jovi's Slippery When Wet, there was a song called Wanted Dead or Alive, which became Bon Jovi's signature song. That's their huge song. And I have a feeling that whoever puts out the Poison records at the time said to the writers, Brett Michaels, who lives right over there, by the way, and CC DeVille, hey, fellas, so power ballads are a massive thing, and also Wanted Dead or Alive was a signature song. Can you do something that is reminiscent of both of those? And so this is a song that has that alludes to cowboys, like Wanted Dead or Alive does, and is a big old 80s power ballad. Not that it's not an earnest and authentic song. Maybe it is. I don't know. According to Brett Michaels, it is. But I feel it's formulaic. I feel someone was behind the scenes saying, hey, Poison, we'd love to sell, we'd love to give you all $1 million bonuses if you write a song like this or something. I don't know how it worked. I wasn't in the music business back then. I'm not in the music business now. That's just my suspicion. Anyway, enough with all that. I'm in my rose dress. I'm going to play an ukulele. I'm going to sing a big old hit song from the 1980s. Every rose has its thorn. Its does not have an apostrophe, by the way. If you're one of those people who writes IT apostrophe S for this song, don't do it. It's like it's his and it's hers. His, hers, its. None of those words have apostrophes. You're welcome. I'm a nerd. You knew that. Anyway, here's the song. Hope you like it. Bye.
Has its own. Though it's been
is. Thanks for watching, everybody. Bye.
Bye. See you next time.